Hello guys, this is Ravens from DJ Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 146. Poco X3 GT launched today globally, but it will not launch in India. Poco X3 GT has been officially launched as a rebranded version of Redmi Note 10 Pro 5G. It features a 6.6-inch 120Hz display, MediaTek Dimensity 1100 processor, and a 5000mAh battery with 67W fast charging support. Poco X3 GT price in US is around $299, that is approximately around 22,000 Indian rupees. Realme is going to launch the MagDot Magnetic Wireless Charging Technology solution in India on August 3rd. Realme CEO Madhav Seth has confirmed that the Realme is holding a Prime Magnetic Innovation event where the MagDot Magnetic Wireless Charging devices have been rendering in the news for the last couple of days. Realme is going all in when it comes to MagDot. MagDot charging technology will be available for all category devices, and Realme is looking forward to democratizing MagDot tech. The Chinese tech brand Realme is being reported to launch the world's first Android smartphone with magnetic wireless charging. The band is yet to verify the official branding of this protocol. We all know that it will be called as Realme MagDot. Airtel has launched a new pack of Rs 79 for its prepaid customers in India. The company has phased out the Rs 49 pack, it is most affordable prepaid plan. The Airtel Rs 79 prepaid plans offers 200 MB 4G data among other benefits. Oppo has partnered with Reliance Jio to conduct 5G trials in Jio's test labs. The Oppo Reno 6 or Reno 6 Pro are chosen for this compatibility with a large range of 5G networks. Jio has successfully tested its SA 5G network using the above Oppo phones. Qualcomm is seemingly nearing the final stages of working on its next generation flagship processor for mobiles. The next chip would be the Snapdragon 895 and come with a certain set of performance improvements. And there is a new leak claims that the chipset will be called as a Qualcomm Snapdragon 898 chipset and also underline the performance specification that chipset could entail. The apparent heart of the chip will apparently be the new generation ARM X2 core. Apple has been reportedly working on launching the iPhone 14 with a full-screen front body with no notches. Now the corporate has just been awarded as a brand new patent for under-display camera for Touch ID and Face ID. Apple earlier this year unveiled the new M1 iMac. The new PC from Apple got a design upgrade with a good bigger screen and a slightly thinner bezels. The 24-inch model also features Apple's custom M1 chip, which is found on the MacBook Pro and MacBook Air models, however. Rumors suggest that Apple will launch a replacement Pro version of its iMac later this year. There is not any official word on the timeline as of now. After increasing the duration of reels from 15 seconds to 30 seconds in September last year, Instagram now lets creators upload up to a 60-second clips on reel. The duration extension comes at a time when the Instagram publicly admitted to it's no longer a photo sharing app, and Instagram announced that creators can now record a 60-second reel through its Twitter handle using the Galaxy Brain meme that dates back in 2017. You can check the announcement tweet on the screen, but honestly, there's not a lot to see there. Xiaomi's Mi bands are highly successful and highly affordable. However, the corporate is also planning something rather high-end dubbed the Mi Band X. A photograph from the presentation leaked and it describes a 360-degree display. The Xiaomi Mi Pad 5 has just been spotted in an exceedingly next week. The real-life image has just surfaced online with its design resembling the iPad Pro from Apple, while another report has revealed that the device will launch with MIUI 12.5 out of the box. Lee Jun, the founder father of Xiaomi, have just shared a replacement recruitment advertisement on his official Weibo account, a Chinese microblogging website. In the teaser image, the corporate is hiring experts within the autonomous driving field on its own automobile unit. Back in March, the Chinese tech giant has announced that it either enter into the smart electric vehicle business with an initial announcement of around 10 billion yuan. That will be roughly around $1.5 billion. Now the chief has officially shared a recruitment ad calling for 500 technical experts in each of Xiaomi autonomous driving department. The social media post states that it is trying to find 500 experts to make its own proprietary self-driving technology for its smart cars. The rumors were true, there are nobody UI 3.5, Samsung is jumping straight to the version 4.0. It supported Android 12 and therefore the company is already recruiting beta tester to do out of it. Samsung Galaxy S21, S21 Plus and S21 Ultra owners are invited to join the beta program, which will go on live soon. And there are no set date for the beginning of One UI 4.0 beta program yet. How long will it go from beta to stable, you will never know with this stuff because it depends upon the percentage issues are covered. But take taking the Note 20 series as an example, One UI 3.0 open beta started in late October, and therefore the stable update was rolled out in mid-December. One UI 3.0 brought Android 11. Ulefone has officially announced a rugged phone called Ulefone Power Armor 13. It packs a huge capacity of 13,200 mAh battery, which is that the best of any rugged smartphone or quite two times bigger than most smartphone normally. The specifications of Ulefone Power Armor 13 is MediaTek Helio G95 chipset, 8GB RAM, 48MP primary camera and a 16MP of front-facing camera. Honor has scheduled a launch event on 12th August where the corporate is launching a new flagship smartphone, the Honor Magic 3. Together with that, the brand is additionally expected to announce a new tablet device dubbed as Honor Tablet V7 Pro. International Data Corporation has today released a brand new report revealing data for the smartphone shipments within the second quarter of this year for the Chinese market. It claims that about 78.1 million units were shipped in China in quarter 2 2021, which represents a decrease of 11% year-on-year sale. Xiaomi's Redmi K50 series will debut later this year. The company has already teased the upcoming Redmi flagship series. It is also confirmed that K50 lineup will have a faster charging support and much better screen. And some of the reports claim that the Redmi K50 series will feature a Qualcomm's next flagship S4C with Snapdragon 895 processor. And there are some reports that vanilla K50 will include a 67W fast charging support. The professional model, on the other hand, will have a charging speeds upwards of around 100W, and the K50 Pro could feature a 120W fast charging support. In the terms of the camera, vanilla model will feature a 48MP primary camera sensor, which is that identical because of the Redmi K40. And there are also some rumors that the professional model will include a 108MP primary camera, and it will also feature a Snapdragon 895 processor or a Snapdragon 898 processor. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe, and follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.